In this video, we are going to see as to how to create a bot for WLM automation. So in the last video, we saw as to how to create a queue, a series of work items. And I have the queue in front of me, which is the mortgage queue. And the mortgage queue has got about 1,000 work items. And to create a bot, the main thing to note is the work item structure. So where do you find the work item structure? So the work item structure is in the work item structure tab, which is the mortgage template queue. This is the name of the work item template or the work item structure. So now let's start creating a bot which can process this queue. For that, I'm going to log in as a bot creator. So I'm going to log out from this profile and I'm going to log in as a bot creator. And once I log in, I'm going to start creating a bot as a create bot, mortgage bot. And I'm going to say create and edit. And as soon as the bot workbench opens, notice the three dots here on the top right. So once the bot workbench loads, we'll link the bot to the queue category. Okay, we'll go into the list view and I'm going to link this bot to the work item template and I'm going to link it to the mortgage template queue and I will drag it to the right side. And notice that when you drag the mortgage template queue, when you associated a bot, you'll also see the work item template attributes, which is the first name, last name, email, address, phone number, amount requested, which is nothing but the header of the CSV or Excel file. And we are then going to save this association and we are going to return to editor. Now, once you associate a bot to the queue, you know, there are two variables which are created for you. Which are the two variables? So in the work item, there is this work item variable, which has got all the data attributes. So the first name, last name, email, address, phone number. So you can actually make use of this variable so that the WLM automation, the WLM manager can pass the information, can pass all these values to the bot via these variables. So if I can have a message box and I say processing work item with first name as variable, and variable work item by name is first name, yes, insert. So when this bot runs, when this bot runs on any device, you know, if it runs on device one, then the work item, it's going to, work WLM manager is going to pass on Michelle. So this bot is going to say Michelle. If the bot runs on device two, it will be Chan. Bot runs on device three, it will be Ilyasa. So that's how you can basically consume the values of the work item from the queue, via this work item variable. And then you can use the business logic. So business logic is compute the mortgage via database command. So database, you connect to a database and then you say insert update, and then you find the customer. So select star from customers where phone number is, then you say work item, and then here you say phone number and you say insert. So the database is going to search for this and it's going to tell you what is the amount sanctioned. For this case, let's say that the amount sanctioned is set 10,000. Now there is a second variable which is there in the variable section, work item result. So how does the bot tell as to what is the amount sanctioned? So work item result, by using this variable, you can basically enable the bot to tell back to the queue that this is the amount sanctioned. So here, the ask is simple. We just have a string assign command. So in the string assign command, you say that the mortgage approved is 10,000 and the variable is work item result. Now this 10,000 is something which is only used for this demo. The value could actually be calculated in the business logic. So this is how you associate a bot to a WLM queue. And once this work item result is populated, you can see the work item result in the, I'm going to save this bot. You can see the work item result in the queues UI. So I'm going to log in as queue admin again. And in the queue UI, you should be able to see the work item result once the work item has been processed by the bot. So in the workload queues, when we go to mortgage queue, you notice there is a column called as work item result. So if I scroll right, so first name, last name, email, address, phone number, amount requested, and work item result. So a bot which calculates the result for that work item, it's going to populate that into this column. So for each and every customer, the bots which are going to run across the devices, each of them are going to compute the mortgages and each of them are going to populate this column. So this is about the video as to how you can associate a bot or you can create a bot to process a WLM queue. Thanks for watching this video.